We began the interpretation of this ayah in the last session, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذْ جَعَلْنَا الْبَيْتَ مَثَابَةً. And we said the word mathaba is the thing that, or the place that the hearts are attached to. And they will continue to return, you know, to this place time and time again. And that's Baytullah al-Haram in Mecca, the sacred house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Mecca. وَأَمْنًا. And we said also it's a safe and secure place for everyone, including in the days of Jahiliyyah, when one would see the killer of his own father walking around the Haram, around the Kaaba, and they would not harm them any, they would give them the safety and security until they exit that place. وَاتَّخِذُوا مِن مَقَامِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ مُصَلَّى. Maqam Ibrahim is the place where after the tawaf we do 2 rak'ahs behind Maqam Ibrahim. That's one interpretation of the ayah. And the other is Maqam Ibrahim as the symbol of Tawheed. The symbol of Tawheed and the symbol of guidance and righteousness, that we should emulate Ibrahim alayhi salam, who is the father of most of the prophets, just like we emulate the best man to walk the face of the earth, which is the Prophet Muhammad. وعهدنا إلى إبراهيم وإسماعيل أن طهر بيتي للطائفين والعاكفين والركع السجود. And we have taken a covenant from Ibrahim عليه السلام and Ismail to purify the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to purify it from any act of shirk, any act of bid'ah, any inappropriate acts that are not suitable to be practiced in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or in the sacred place that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made in Mecca. وَإِذْ قَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ رَبِّ اجْعَلْ هَذَا بَلَدًا آمِنًا وَارْزُقْ أَهْلَهُ مِنَ الثَّمَرَاتِ مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. Here Ibrahim alayhi salam is supplicating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in many supplications, where he says, O Allah, make this house, or make this balad, you know, this town, Mecca, baladan amina, means a safe and secure place. And we all feel that when we go to Mecca. No one is feeling insecure about, you know, for himself, or for his family, or for his property. It is not even something that comes to mind. So it is a safe and secure place for everyone to go visit. وَرْزُقْ أَهْلَهُ مِنَ الثَّمَرَاتِ مَنْ آمَنَ مِنْهُمْ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. Here in this supplication, Ibrahim alayhi salam make it a stipulation or a restriction that only gives sustenance to those who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Judgment Day. But it's the sunnah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give sustenance, to give this worldly material things to those who believe and those who disbelieve. And it's no measure for the satisfaction or the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if he's to give a believer abundance of wealth, or to give a kafir, a disbeliever, abundance of wealth. This dunya, it is negligible to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so he gives the believer and the disbeliever in it, and then he says, وَمَنْ كَفَرْ فَأُمَتِّعُهُ قَلِيلًا. As for the one who disbelieves, I shall entertain him a little bit in this dunya, and then I shall make him depart or part ways with this dunya in a dislike fashion. Mukrah means something to against their will. ثُمَّ أَطَّرُّهُ. Then in the hereafter I shall punish him severely. وَبِئْسَ الْمَصِيرُ. وَإِذْ يَرْفَعُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ الْقَوَاعِدَ مِنَ الْبَيْتِ وَإِسْمَاعِيلُ رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا. Here a host or a slew of ad'iyah, supplications that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioned to us that Ibrahim alayhi salam has made as he was commanded to erect the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with his son Ismail. وَإِذْ يَرْفَعُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ الْقَوَاعِدَ مِنَ الْبَيْتِ وَإِسْمَاعِيلُ رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا. In spite of the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has tested Ibrahim and has tested Ismail and has honored them, and he has made Ibrahim alayhi salam imam lil muttaqeen, and he has commanded our Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم to follow his footsteps. ثُمَّ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ أَنِ اتَّبِعْ مِلَّةَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ حَنِيفًا. Then we have sent you the wahi, O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, to follow the millah of Ibrahim عليه السلام. In spite of this very high status that Ibrahim عليه السلام has reached, no arrogance. He was not a conceited person. He was not an arrogant person, وَالْعِيَادَ بِاللَّهِ. He continued to supplicate, knowing that two elements will rise a person to that level of honor, which is number one, al-ilmun nafi', knowledge that is beneficial. والعمل الصالح, and deeds that are righteous. And the righteous deeds, as we learn from the Sunnah, are the deeds that are offered when one, the first condition was one, is a Muslim. And the second, that this deed is offered with the purity of intention for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no one else. And third, that is consistent with the teachings of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, means that it's following the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as he commanded us to follow in all acts of worship. So all of these conditions must exist for the deed to be acceptable to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So بالعلم النافع, beneficial knowledge, والعمل الصالح, and the righteous deeds, one's status is elevated in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as he says, إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ. The most honorable among you in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are the most pious, the most righteous. رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا. So Ibrahim alayhi salam did not take it for granted that I'm a leader for the righteous now, I'm an imam, so therefore whatever I do is going to be accepted. No, they're always still supplicating, knowing that he's rendering this ibadah to the one who's not in need of it. To the one who's not in need of it. رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. You are the all-hearer, you are the all-seer. رَبَّنَا وَاجْعَلْنَا مُسْلِمَيْنِ لَكَ وَمِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِنَا أُمَّةً مُسْلِمَةً لَكَ. Oh Allah, and make us what? Muslims. Notice this is the dua of Ibrahim alayhi salam. This is like thousands of years before the coming of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So when one is asking you, who are you, what group you belong to, what sex, so on and so forth, the simple answer to that is the answer that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us to give in the Quran. The answer that Ibrahim alayhi salam is supplicating for Allah, وَجْعَلْنَا مُسْلِمَيْن. Muslimayn means al-khudu' wal-istislam. Khudu' means to submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in obedience. Istislam, to surrender to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in all acts of commandments, affirmative actions, and all acts of prohibitions, negative actions. Do this, don't do this. So therefore, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, هُوَ سَمَّاكُمُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that has given you this name as a Muslim. مِنْ قَبْلِ. Means that مِنْ قَبْلِ is before the revelation of this Quran. And that's why we hear Ibrahim alayhi salam, he was saying, O Allah, make us Muslimayn. Make us among the Muslims. And وفي هذا, and in this Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala consistently used the same name, Muslim. And the word Muslim, as we just explained, al-khudu' wal-istislam. To submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in complete obedience and to surrender to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in all matters. In all matters. رَبَّنَا وَاجْعَلْنَا مُسْلِمَيْنِ لَكَ وَمِنْ ذُرُّيَّتِنَا أُمَّةً مُسْلِمَةً لَكَ وَأَرِنَا مَنَاسِكَنَا. And show us and teach us all acts of ibadat. Manasik al-Hajj and beyond that. Manasik al-Hajj and beyond that. وَتُبْ عَلَيْنَا. And notice here, Ibrahim alayhi salam is asking for forgiveness. Why? Because it doesn't matter how knowledgeable a person becomes. It doesn't matter how good and how perfect their deeds may seem. There has to be some level of deficiency. Why? Because by default, we are a deficient creation. We are a deficient creation. We are not really a creation that is suitable to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as He ought to be worshipped. So we'll always make mistakes, we'll forget, our ibadah is deficient, we may get ill, you know, things happen that render our ibadah to be subservient to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, accepts from us. However, with the asking for the tawbah and the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts these deeds from us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts these deeds from us. And the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ confirms that when he says, every person enters paradise by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then when they ask, O Prophet of Allah, and you, he said, and I. In spite of the fact that when we look at the ibadat of the Prophet ﷺ, it's our ceiling. No one can even come close to it. But in spite of that, he himself said, including myself, I enter paradise with the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. رَبَّنَا وَبْعَثْ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا مِّنْهُمْ يَتْلُوْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِكَ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمْ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. O Allah, and send from among them, from his dhurriya, from his offspring, Rasul. Who is this Rasul? It is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's why in the hadith the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells us, أنا دعوة أبي إبراهيم. I am the supplication of my forefather Ibrahim عليه السلام. This teaches us something here. Notice the dua was made thousands of years before the sending of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, right? And the ijaba, you know, the response came, you know, thousands of years later. When we make a dua, we learn from the sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم that one of three things happen. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would immediately grant us this dua, the response to our dua. Or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will wipe out equivalent number of sins from our account, if you will. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will wipe out sins for the dua or equivalent to the dua that we've made. Or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will save that dua for us until we most need it. Like when we go in our graves. Or on Judgment Day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would save this dua for us because He knows that this is when you need it most. And that's what we say, and we also learn from the dua of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allahumma la takilni li nafsi tarfata 'ayni. Oh Allah, do not leave me to myself, not even a period, of a blink of an eye. A period of even a blink of an eye, because I could do harm to myself. I could supplicate with something that is negative for me. I could, wal'iyadu billah, even to the extent exit the state of Islam into a state of apostasy by one word that one may utter. So the Prophet ﷺ himself, in spite of the guidance and the divine revelations and the blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the ismah, protection from making errors in matters of the sharia, he still supplicates to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not to leave him to himself, not even a period that lasts the blink of an eye. That's a split second, if you will. ربنا وابعث فيهم رسولا منهم يتلو عليهم آياتك ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة. يعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة means to teach them the divine revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And الحكمة by definition is فعل ما ينبغي كما ينبغي في الوقت الذي ينبغي. Do what is needed of you, what you've been commanded to do, as you've been commanded to do it, in the time that you are commanded to do it. I'll just give one example. When we try to apply hikmah to our salah, فعل ما ينبغي is to pray. We are all of age, right? We've reached the age of puberty. So we are commanded to pray and to render our salah according to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, with its arkan, all of its pillars, its sunan, all of its sunan, and its conditions, all of its conditions. That's فعل ما ينبغي. كما ينبغي, right? Like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has taught us. So we pray like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has taught us, في الوقت الذي ينبغي, in the time that we're supposed to pray. So if I pray Maghrib at the time of Asr, it's not acceptable. If I pray Asr in the time of Dhuhr, it's not acceptable. Okay? So this is what hikmah means, doing what you're supposed to do, like you're supposed to do it, like you've been taught by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam how to do it, at the time that you are supposed to do it. So you cannot go perform Hajj, you know, in the month of Ramadan. No, you perform Hajj in the month of Hajj. Right? You cannot fast the month of Ramadan in another month. It won't work. It has to be at that time. رَبَّنَا وَبْعَثْ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا مِّنْهُمْ يَتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِكَ وَيُعَلِّمْهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ. So all of this knowledge, all of this wisdom, all of these righteous deeds in order for us to achieve tazkiyah. And this is the measure, this is the criterion by which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala determines the success of a soul. As he says, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا وَقَدْ خَابَ مَنْ دَسَّاهَا. That those who are successful are those who practice self-tazkiyah, who purify themselves from the ills and the evils of this world, and who aspire to come close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by way of the teachings of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, by way of the divine revelation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. Indeed, you are the Almighty. You are the All-Wise. You do everything you do according to predisposed ways, according to pre-decreed ways. إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. That nothing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does, no actions whatsoever emanates from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, except that they are by way of His will. His will is present, and by way of His wisdom, and He has the infinite wisdom. And we'll continue inshallah in the next ayat where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ يَرْغَبُ عَنْ مِلَّةِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ إِلَّا مَنْ سَفِيهَ نَفْسَهُ. None deviates from the millah of Ibrahim عليه الصلاة والسلام except those who disgrace themselves. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who honor themselves, follow the millah of Ibrahim عليه السلام, follow the sunnah of our beloved Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. أقول قولي هذا واستغفروه سبحانك اللهم بحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين جزاكم الله خيرا السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.